Welcome back to the oneAPI channel. We are visual creatures. We all love the beautiful, realistic, computer-generated scenes in the movies. Scientists are getting insights from visualization of big data, and designers are using visualization to design their next products. Pretty complex software tools are required in order to create these amazing visual effects, simulation animations, or architecture models. And the one-stop shop for these software tools is the Intel oneAPI Rendering Toolkit. In previous videos, we've talked about the oneAPI components. We mentioned the multi-device, multi-vendor, open-spec libraries that can now work on multiple devices, CPU, GPU, and others, what we call XPUs, and are arranged into toolkits. One of them is the oneAPI Rendering Toolkit. The oneAPI Rendering Toolkit is designed from the ground up to accelerate heavy computational workloads like ray tracing, volumetric rendering, and image denoising. The Rendering Toolkit is highly optimized for Intel CPUs, but we're working to make the same code portable to Intel future XPUs. So you can start working right now on Intel Xeon CPUs, for example, and then seamlessly port the code to Intel discrete GPUs. And the full API specification of the Rendering Toolkit components are published. Look them up and implement your own version on your hardware. The Rendering Toolkit has many components. Let's take a closer look at each one of them. Each of these components will be presented in detail in a dedicated video. We'll talk about the value of each of them, how to use it, where to find resources, and sample code. They are all open source, easy to use, and will get you started in minutes in each relevant video. Look for them. The Academy Award Technical Achievement Award recipient, Intel Embree, is a collection of performance-optimized ray tracing kernels aimed at graphic engineers who want to improve the performance of their photorealistic rendering application. The Embree library is used by many leading production renderers, but you can also use it standalone yourself. Look for the Embree video. Open Image Denoise is a high-quality, efficient, and easy-to-use denoising library powered by machine learning algorithms that allow developers to significantly reduce rendering times in ray tracing-based applications that generate final frames or light maps. The Open Volume Kernel Library, simply referred to as OpenVKL, is a collection of high-performance volume computation kernels. So if you're looking to improve the volume rendering for objects like smoke, you can see in this image, clouds, and so on, OpenVKL is your library. OSPRay is an easy-to-use rendering library that allows developers to easily build ray tracing-based interactive applications, including both surface and volume-based visualization. It runs on modern CPUs from laptop to workstation and onto compute nodes on HPC systems, and of course, soon, on GPUs. OSPRay is using under the hood the capabilities of Intel Embree for ray tracing, the OpenVKL for volume computation, and the Open Image Denoise for improving the image quality. OSPRay Studio is an interactive visualization and ray tracing application that leverages OSPRay as its base, so you can load a very complex scene and move the point of view or the light sources around or play with multiple parameters, and it's all being rendered in real time. Not so simple. OSPRay for Hydra is a plugin for the Pixar Universal Scene Description System, known as USD, and extend the USD Hydra rendering framework with OSPRay. It enables interactive scene preview by utilizing the OSPRay high-quality renderers and open image denoising. And the last one, OpenSWR, scalable, high-performance software rasterizer. Basically, a high-performance, highly scalable OpenGL compatible software that can seamlessly run your OpenGL code on CPU. These are all the components of the oneAPI Rendering Toolkit. You can download the Rendering Toolkit or any of the components separately. They are all built on top of Intel optimized libraries for the best possible performance. You can install it on your machine or try it out on the Intel Dev Cloud. Please check the dedicated short videos for each of the components for more details on the usage, where to find the spec, how to install and run code samples. See you there.